Iran's window to seek and obtain a peaceful resolution will not remain open forever.
That was U.S. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, who spoke this past Saturday in Saudi Arabia to discuss a common defense against Iran. So for more, we are joined from the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange by renowned Iranian studies scholar and founding director of the Center for Iranian Studies at Tel Aviv University, David Menashri. Menashri is Israel's top Iran expert in terms of sanctions and oil policy. So, David, you heard Secretary of State Hillary Clinton there saying the window will not be open for Iran. Do you see any change with Iran's behavior in reaction to the sanctions?
Well, let me begin by saying that Iran, unlike what many people think, Iran is weak and vulnerable. And Iran has proven since the beginning of the revolution, 33 years ago, that wherever they have to decide between their interest and their policy or ideology, they opt for their interest. So I believe that Iran is pressurable, and pressure can deliver. And I believe that in the last few months, we can see some rethinking, I would say not only in Iran, including also in Israel and in the world, and the harsh rhetorics at the turn of the year, December, January, have somehow turn their place to more quiet. It doesn't mean that if you are quiet, nothing is going to happen, but people realize that the escalation of rhetorics is not doing good to any of the parties.
But we've seen the sanctions. In fact, Bloomberg News had an illuminating piece about how Iran is using Chinese yuan, Indian rupees, even wheat as a method of trade because it's cut off from dollars and euros in its oil trade. So how are the sanctions impacting Iran? How dire of a situation is it on the ground there?
Well, you know, if you take one example, is the rate of the Iranian currency, the rial, and you can see that the considerable drop of 30-40% in 4 or 5 months in the value of the rial. And I think people in Iran are very concerned because they realize that although it's not clear when and if an action is being taken, but it talks about military option and pressure on the Iranian economy and the Iranian banks have caused concern. Sometimes I even thought it's more than concern, almost panic in the market when it comes to the currency. There is the people of Iran are, after 33 years of Islamic revolution, are not very happy with the results of the revolution. The revolution was not about the return to Islam. The revolution was about to provide better life to the people of Iran. It was a revolution for bread and liberties, and this has not been satisfied. So I don't think that only the people are concerned, but the regime itself is concerned, because given the realities in the region, I think that they are aware that what happened in the Arab world can also happen in Iran.
All right, thank you for that perspective. David Menashri, who is from the Tel Aviv University, on the latest on how Iranian sanctions are impacting the people and the economy there.